Hola, ¿qué tal amigos de Telehit? Bueno, aquí estamos con el DJ número uno pues, del mundo y para mí es un placer presentarles, por supuesto, a Armin Van Buuren. Y pues, it's a pleasure to be here with you today. Thanks a lot, first of all, like, for the interview. Actually, I was with, every time I'm with, like, a DJ or trying to interview someone, I'm really interested, like, about the emotion that really brings, like, to you or the feelings that you have, like, in the middle of everything and the rush of, like, seeing the crowd and the connection from it. What do you like feel exactly when you're there, like on the top and like your crowd is there just asking for more and more and like dancing your music, thing that like, I don't know, it must be like amazing, right? Like a very awesome feeling.
Well, it's not always easy because what you see on TV sometimes is like the crowd going crazy, but sometimes you have like little flat gigs and you have to find your way to really, you know, energize the crowd. And there's certain tricks to do that. I mean.
What tricks?
Well, yeah.
Just give me one, come on.
No, you look at the crowd. I mean, what is, a lot of people ask me, like, what's so special about a DJ? I mean, people dig a rock band because they're playing guitar and they're singing and playing the drums or whatever. A DJ is basically playing tracks from other people and looking good by doing so. So I can understand the frustration with a lot of people, but what I always say is, like, you're a good DJ based on your timing. It's all about timing. So you look at the crowd. For example, very, very simple example. If you're standing on a dance floor and there's not really a vibe going and you see the women walking away, then you're having a really tough job. What you females, usually women, usually like more vocals. So if you throw in a little vocal track here and there, it works. And if the women come, the guys usually stay, you know. This is just how it goes.
So you're good, huh? You know how it works.
It's very simple, basic rules. It's not like that I use that every time and every gig, but, you know, I think every DJ will tell you the same story, that no matter how popular you are, or everybody plays for a half-empty venue sometimes. You
know? Yeah.
Something goes completely wrong, and then, but you still have, I think it's your character that decides if the night will go off or not, you know.
So that's why you're number one, you're DJ number one in the world. How did that feel for you?
Ah, it feels amazing. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, to be honest, I'm not waking up in the morning thinking like,
oh my God, number one.
No, but, and also like, oh, how can I retain my number one position? That's not like on my mind. The most important thing that's on my mind is, okay, you know, I'm gonna work in studio today with Ferry Corsten. He's coming over, doing a track together. Or Fiora, a singer that I really admire, is coming over to the studio. We're working on an actual song today. This is amazing, you know? And I think that's the essence of everything. The music should always be the most important, in my opinion.